Maybe the new person is in there?
We're finally here. I'm pretty late, though. I just know I'm gonna get yelled at. Okay, Stirk. I'd better get going.
Sure. Thanks for your help. Be careful on your way back.
You're late, Stirk. You've messed up my entire schedule.
Sorry, Esty. It was such short notice, I wasn't even able to get everything ready before I left.
I'll listen to your excuses later. Right now, I need you to investigate a dragon that showed up recently.
Of course, as soon as possible. Also, I was hoping I could introduce myself to the Arl's royal family.
Uh-huh. Old night habits die hard, huh, Stirk? Don't worry about the princess. I'll be escorting her myself.
That's not what I meant. I just wanted to report my arrival to Lord Dessier and Princess Meruru Vince.
Wow, so you've done your homework. But sorry, your job is to look into the dragon stalking the eastern frontier. But I do plan on assigning you as Princess Meruru's escort once that's finished.
Did I just hear my name?
Oh, Meruru, what are you doing here?
I saw the carriage come in from Arland, so I wanted to see if someone new had arrived. Is this him?
That's right. His skill with a sword is unparalleled. His only character flaw is that frightful face of his.
Oh, so his face is... Gah! I'm sorry! I just noticed you so suddenly. I couldn't help myself.
No worries. I'm used to it. But your name's Meruru. What a coincidence to share the princess's name.
Stirk, you dolt! You're speaking to Arl's...
Excuse me. My name is Sturkenberg Cronach. It's a pleasure to meet you.
Yes. Mr. Storkerberg.
It's difficult to pronounce, I know. You can call me Stirk.
Okay. Mr. Stirk, my name is Meruru.
Please, there's no need to call me Mr. Just Stirk will do.
Well, but you're older than me, right? So I'd feel better calling you Mr.
Then it would be my honor. I, Sturkenberg, will vouchsafe my duties with my life.
Of course. Just, don't push yourself too hard.
Sorry, Meruru. This man is... complicated. Oh, and as for myself... as ordered by Geo, head of the Arland Republic, I will see to all of your needs as your escort. Further... Sturkenberg has a pressing matter to attend to and will assume escort duties once that is settled.
Oh yeah? Okay, well, thank you, I guess. But why are you guys being so formal right now?
Well, it just seemed like the proper time to be formal.
So, Esty, once I finish my investigation, I'll be allowed to act as Princess Meruru's escort?
You got it. Geo has personally requested that you resolve your assigned duties and then help protect her.
Poor Geo? Does he not realize how much extra work he creates for me? Even going so far as making me help at a workshop. And now he's got the guild helping with Arl's development, dispatching adventurers, and ordering investigations. You're not hiding something from me, are you?
I have no idea what you're talking about. Regardless, after you're finished, you will be her escort.
Sorry my kingdom is causing you so much trouble. But I'm doing my best, and I'd love to have your support.
Those are the words I've longed to hear. You can count on me, Princess. I swear to protect you with my life.
sense when you start talking all serious like that.
I'd better go finish my assignment. But is he really dwelling in this kingdom right now?
Who, Uncle Geo? Yeah, he spends a lot of time at Heart Outpost.
Heart Outpost? I see. I'd better pay him a visit right away.
Gosh, your eyes are so scary right now. Do you even know where Heart Outpost is?
It doesn't matter. I can sense when he's nearby. I have so many questions for him. Princess, if you'll excuse me.
He's gone. Is Mr. Stirk always like that?
Whenever Geo's involved, yep. But part of it is because you're a princess, so there's nothing we can do about that.
I see. Well, I hope everything turns out okay.
What's the matter, young miss? Your face looks so poor.
What? What do you mean, poor? I am the princess of this kingdom, you know. Jeez.
Well, I mean, you know, your atmosphere. Like something awful has befallen you. You want to talk about it?
It's kind of hard to admit, but in the castle...
Is that it? You seem so depressed all because of that?
Well, cause... I don't know a lot of people like that, so plus...
Say no more! I've told you before, I put all my effort into everything I do. Just leave it to me. Bad shape before, but it should be all better now.
That was amazing! He fixed it in no time, and now it moves so smoothly.
Indeed, and I have a chim checking the areas around the pipes too, so if you'll wait just a bit... It seems he's all done. That was fast. All right, let me go check that.
Delicate and precise than I was expecting. I'm very impressed. I know you meant that as a compliment, but I'm glad he didn't hear you say that.
Really? They say you're not supposed to judge people just by their looks.
But you just... I mean...
Yo! Everything looks good! I'd like to take a crack at fixing the cauldron in the kitchen, but it'll take some time.
don't have to go to all that trouble. You've already been such a huge help.
No trouble at all! I'll come back whenever I get some free time. And don't be afraid to ask for my help again. Compared to what I do at the weapon store, this is a piece of cake. And this gym is surprisingly useful. Besides, I didn't come to Arles just to sell weapons. This is well within my area of expertise. Right, Jim?
Oh, thank you too, Jim. I wish there was some way I could show my appreciation.
I told you, don't worry about it. That's the whole point of helping others.
Why don't you at least come with us and enjoy a little tea?
Ho ho! Now that would be a real treat. Nothing's more refreshing than a nice drink after working so hard. Your tea is more than enough thanks for today's effort.
You know, Mr. Hagel, Kana's tea is the best drink in the whole wide world. People come to Arles from all over to help make it better. And making it better brings in even more people. I guess this is how the kingdom can change, little by little.
Chipper than last time I saw you.
That voice! Esty? I thought you were out of town on that investigation.
I still have that. But I also have my assignment to act as the personal escort for Princess Meruru Lin's raid Arles.
Why are you trying to sound so fancy? Just talk normal.
I see. Tell me right away if my sister treats you poorly in any way whatsoever.
Hey, standing right here, you know. Don't forget, you can still be fired if you don't do your job.
I know that, but I'm not like I was before. Seriously, though, Meruru.
Be careful.
Sometimes she just disappears all of a sudden, getting herself involved in who knows what behind closed doors. So you're better off not relying on her too much. If you need someone, put your money on Mr. Sturt.
Knock it off already! Don't go filling her innocent mind with your nonsense! You make it sound like I'm into all these backdoor dealings! Don't believe anything she says, okay, Meruru?
You two are so funny together. I don't have any sisters, so I'm kind of jealous.
Meruru... Okay then, maybe I'll take you on as my younger sister and get rid of Philly.
Don't forget how old you are. In Meruru's eyes, you're more of an aunt than a sister.
Philly, you're my sister, but there are some things you just don't say.
Why not? It's the truth, isn't it? I'm a way better fit for Meruru's older sister.
You're reaching that age where you can't make fun of other women. Your standards are too high. It's almost too late.
I still have plenty of time. I'm only 20 or something. You're already in your 4.
Don't say another word. You're my but I won't hesitate to.
Ah! Miss Esty, put your sword away! That's not the proper response to the situation! I think of you both as my older sisters! Honestly, please stop this insanity!
to dodge this. I'm okay!
Way to go, guys! Yeah! That was easy! get this over with! Ah! Ha!
Lickety-split! Here it comes!
Total victory!
Leave it to me!